Good morning.
Good morning.
For those watching at home, please participate in the Mass as much as you can by saying the responses and prayers aloud and by standing, kneeling, and sitting at the appropriate times. To help you to participate, there is a worship aid on our website. Just go to the live streaming media section of our website, stdenis.org. S-T-D-E-N-I-S, and click on the worship aid. In addition, you can type your prayer intentions into the comments section on Facebook or YouTube, because during the universal prayer, we will lift up to God all of the prayers in the comments section. Thank you. Creatures of our God and King.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome everyone to this Mass here at St. Denis Catholic Church in Diamond Bar, California, as we celebrate on this Saturday in the fifth week of Easter. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let's first acknowledge our sins. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, who through the regenerating power of baptism have been pleased to confer on us heavenly life, grant, we pray, that those you render capable of immortality, by justifying them, may by your guidance attain the fullness of glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul reached also Derbe and Lystra, where there was a disciple named Timothy, the son of a Jewish woman who was a believer, but his father was a Greek. The brothers in Lystra and Iconium spoke highly of him, and Paul wanted him to come along with him. On account of the Jews of that region, Paul had him circumcised, for they all knew that his father was a Greek. As they traveled from city to city, they handed on to the people for observance the decisions reached by the apostles and presbyters in Jerusalem. Day after day, the churches grew stronger in faith and increased in number. They traveled through Phrygian and Galatian territory because they had been prevented by the Holy Spirit from preaching the message in the province of Asia. When they came to Mysia, they tried to go on into Bithynia, but the Spirit of Jesus did not allow them, so they crossed through Mysia and came down to Troas. During the night, Paul had a vision. A Macedonian stood before him and implored him with these words, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." When he had seen the vision, we sought passage to Macedonia at once, concluding that God had called us to proclaim the good news to them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If the world hates you, realize that it hated me first. If you belonged to the world would love its own. But because you do not belong to the world, I have chosen you out of the world hates you. Remember the word I spoke to you. No slave is greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they kept my word, they will also keep yours. And they will do all these things to you on account of my name, because they do not know the one who sent me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
During the Easter season, the first reading at every Mass is from the Acts of the Apostles, which describes how the early Christian church, which started in Jerusalem, grew and spread throughout the Roman Empire. As today's first reading from Acts summarizes, day by day, or day after day, the churches grew stronger in faith and increased in number. All of this was possible because of the Holy Spirit, who led and guided the first apostles. For example, today's first reading says that the apostle Paul and his co-worker Timothy traveled through the Phrygian and Galatian territory because they were prevented by the Holy Spirit from preaching the good news of Jesus Christ in the province of Asia. And when they tried to go to Bithynia, the Holy Spirit did not allow them. Then, through the Holy Spirit, Paul had a vision of a Macedonian inviting him to come to Macedonia. And so Paul and Timothy went at once to Macedonia to proclaim the good news to the Macedonians. In everything, Paul and Timothy were open to the guidance of the Holy Spirit, and they did not delay or drag their feet. And consequently, Christianity spread from the Holy Land into Europe, which is what today's first reading describes. In the same way, we too must be open to the guidance of the Holy Spirit in our lives and do at once whatever the Spirit calls us to do. God was able to do great things through Paul and Timothy because they did not resist the Holy Spirit's guidance. And God can do great things through us if we also are completely attentive and obedient to the Spirit. And please stand. Taking comfort in the Lord's mercy, let us offer to him our prayers and petitions. For those discerning a vocation to the service of the church through the priesthood or religious life, may the Holy Spirit's gifts of fortitude and wisdom guide them in their decision making. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in public office, may the Lord help them face the challenges of their duties with patience and discretion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For family members experiencing discord, may their hearts be open to the light of Christ and bring them reconciliation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For young people, who are gathered with us in our virtual Mass community. May the Lord make known his will for them as they seek their life's meaning and purpose. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they be welcomed into paradise by the risen Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intentions of this Mass, for all of the mothers who are listed in our Mother's Day Novena, and for the repose of the soul of Antonio Calingacion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of those who need our prayers, and for all of the prayer intentions that are listed in the comments section on Facebook or YouTube, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear the prayers we bring to you through your Son, Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care, they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and, once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The Mystery of Faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. And for those of you who are watching from home, I encourage you to offer a sign of peace to others in your household, even if they're not watching Mass with you. Or you can type in a sign of peace into the comments section and offer the peace of Christ to others in our virtual Mass community.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis.
Now let us pray the prayer of spiritual communion by St. Alphonsus Liguori. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My soul is filled with joy as I sing to God, my Savior. You have looked upon your servant. You have visited your people, and holy is your name. Everlasting is your mercy to the people you have chosen, and holy is your name. I am lowly as a child, but I know from this day forward that my name will be remembered, for all will call me blessed, and holy is your name. Everlasting is your mercy to the people you have chosen, and holy is your name. I proclaim the power of God. You do marvels for your servants. Though you scatter the proud-hearted and destroy the might of the princes, and holy is your name. Generations, everlasting is your mercy to the people you have chosen, and holy is your name.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that, redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I think we have some announcements, or no? I have some announcements, but I'm supposed to do it from over here. Thank you, everyone, for joining us for this Mass today. Please join us every day for one of our live-streamed Masses. We live-stream a Mass every weekday, Monday through Saturday at 8 a.m. And on Sunday, we live-stream two Masses, a 10:30 a.m. Mass with a cantor and an organ and piano, and a 5:30 p.m. Mass with more contemporary music for youths, young adults, and others. And please stay with us today and join us. I'm looking over at Jay, who is behind the camera. 9 a.m., 9:30. We are going to do a May crowning at 9:30 a.m. today. We originally scheduled it for 9 a.m., but that was a little too ambitious. We need to set up the cameras in a different location and set up everything in that other location. So please join us at 9:30 a.m. today for a live-streamed crowning of the statue of the Blessed Virgin Mary here in the church at St. Denis. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures below. Praise Him above ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. That dwell below the skies, let the creatures praise or rise, let the redeemers make me sigh. Oh, be thou.